Namaste Gurukulians, how are you? Hope all of you are healthy, fit and fine at your home. So in my previous video, I have taught you the first part of the portrait of a lady written by Khushwant Singh. Clear? So today I will tell you the next further part. As I have depicted, Khushwant Singh, he is an Indian writer. He was an Indian writer because he died in 2014. He was a journalist, he was a columnist, he was an advocate, and he was a good writer of English literature. So many creativities he has provided to the world. All the things I have told in my previous video, those who have not gone through, so please kindly pay a visit to there and you will get the complete information about his life. Clear? So this is an autobiography. The Portrait of a Lady is an autobiography of the writer himself, and which he has depicted it in three phases, three parts. Part 1, Part 2 and Part 3. Phase 1, which I have already depicted in a previous video. In Part 1, I have told when Khushwant Singh, he was left under the observation of his grandmother by his parents. When parents, both of them, mother and father, got shifted to city for earning their livelihood and money. Clear? So, there the grandmother, she used to awake the writer in the early morning, and she prepared him for the school, and she provided him wooden slate plastered with white chalk and so many other things she used to do, like she offered him the heavy breakfast with some stale chapatis with some bread and sugar over it, and both of them, they left for the school. Then the school was located in the temple and their priest used to teach all of them. Meanwhile, the grandmother, she kept sitting inside the temple in order to read the scriptures in the afternoon, when both of them, they had finished their work and they started moving back to their homes. Clear? So on their returning back, the grandmother, she started throwing some pieces of stale chapatis which she had carried in the early morning along with her, and the dogs were fighting and grumbling to each other in order to find a single piece of chapatis. So up to here I had told you this was the part number 1. So part 2 gets started when the grandmother and grandson, the writer himself, both of them, they got shifted to city. Clear? What happened in city? What were things were going on? I am gonna tell you today itself. Please pay attention and have a book in your hand. This is the book Hornbill. Clear? And here the page number 4. Right? So we are going to start. I need your concentration. Clear?
Yeah. The Portrait of a Lady, written by Khushwant Singh.
Clear? Khushwant Singh. The Portrait of a Lady, Khushwant Singh, second part, page number 4. This is the page number, bachcho. You can see this is page number and third paragraph. From here onwards we are going to start. Have a pen and pencil in your hand in order to write down the difficult words which I am going to write down on the board. Clear? Good. So, the first part little bit it was pending, so let me finish it. My grandmother always went to school, means grandmother and grandson, the writer, both of them, they went to the school because the school was attached to the temple. There was a temple in the village, so school was located along with the temple. The priest of the temple, he taught us the alphabet. The priest was there in the temple and he used to make all the children sit in the veranda and started asking all of them to chant the alphabets behind him, and the morning prayer as well, as which you are doing morning prayer, suppose whenever you are coming to school and you have to do the morning prayer in the same manner. The school was there, obviously that definitely the priest, he had to make adjustment for the morning assembly, and he started doing morning prayer with the students. Clear? Then the priest taught us the alphabet and the morning prayer. While the children sat in rows on each side of the veranda, sing the alphabet or the morning prayer in a chorus. Meanwhile, the children, they started sitting one this side, one another this side. Clear? On both rows, the children used to sit as they started following the instruction to be given by the priest. And they started chanting the alphabets. For example, A for apple, B for ball. एंड एट दैट टाइम ही यूज्ड टू स्पीक इन हिंदी लाइक अ अनार आ आम छोटी असेंबली बड़ी इसे एक सो दीज टाइम ऑफ काइंड्स ऑफ अल्फाबेट्स ही स्टार्टेड टीचिंग टू लिटिल चिल्ड्रन एंड ऑल ऑफ देम दे स्टार्टेड फॉलोइंग वट एवर ही हैड बीन स्पीकिंग क्लियर ओके सो इन अ कॉरस कॉरस मीन्स कलेक्टिवली ओके सी एच ओ आर यू एस कॉरस मीन्स कलेक्टिवली सिंगिंग means in group whenever you are going to sing so all the children collectively they used to follow the alphabets whatever it had been said by the priest himself right so my grandmother meanwhile she sat inside reading the scriptures scriptures means the religious books clear so scriptures she started reading by sitting inside the temple and here underline one thing the grandmother she was not illiterate she was literate because she could read and write clear so when we both had finished in the afternoon when grandmother she had finished her work when I had finished my schooling so both of us we started we would walk back together means we started moving back to our home this time the village dogs in the village so many dogs used to be there they would meet us they were waiting curiously eagerly curiously they started waiting for grandmother because they knew very well grandmother definitely she would throw some stale chapatis towards them and they were hungry at the temple door they kept waiting for me and my grandmother at the temple door they followed us then started following me and my grandmother to our home and till our home they started following both of us growling growling means producing sound in Hindi translation gurrana like this is growling clear so growling and fighting they started fighting with each other for the chapatis we threw to them we started throwing the chapatis to them and my parents so this is the second part this is a turning point boys please pay attention when my parents were comfortably settled in the city in the previous part I had told you ki means Kushwant Singh had been left by his parents under the observation of his grandmother now this time mother and father the parents of Kushwant Singh the writer they had well settled into the city they had earned enough money and after that they sent for us sent for means calling they sent for it's a phrasal verb to call someone clear and someone means head relates to grandmother and the writer so they had been both of them had been sent for in the city they had been called into the city now this was really a turning point in the lifestyle of the grandmother and the writer Kushwant Singh because complete change a drastic sudden change had been occurred in both of their lives what kind of changes had been done please pay attention here so this was a turning point means sudden change it was a sudden change in our friendship now this time me and my grandmother who both were close friends to each other now this time the segregation was about to be started segregation means separation clear alag alag so separation was about to be started although we shared the room although halaki means even then we had been sharing I Kushwant Singh along with my grandmother we shared the room I used to sleep with my grandmother I used to live with my grandmother but my grandmother no longer came to school with me now this time my mother she never came to my school because what happened I used to go to an English school he was admitted it means the writer was admitted to an English school what happened in village life bachcho means in the village life Kushwant Singh was dropped at the school by his grandmother now this time in the school he was admitted to an English school in the city he was admitted to an English school and there a motor bus was arranged for him clear so there were no dogs in the street nothing would be there like what was going on in the school in the city so village life and she took to feeding sparrows in the courtyard of our city house whatever the house was there which had been occupied which had been purchased by my parents in the city there she used to make herself sit in the courtyard in the veranda itself okay and started throwing some breadcrumbs to so many birds sparrows pigeons crows they started coming and started sitting around my grandmother in this way Now pay attention in part number one, when both of them, they used to live in the village, there the grandmother, she used to feed the dogs, and now in the city she used to feed sparrows. Clear? As the years rolled by, with the passage of time, years after years had been passed away, we saw less of each other. We started looking very, very less to each other because I was busy in my life and she got lost in her work. Clear? For sometime she continued to wake me up, but sometime, maybe once a month, maybe after 2 months, after 3 months, she used to awake me up in the early morning like she had been doing in the village life and get me ready for the school, and sometimes she prepared me for the school. But when I came back from the school in the afternoon, I used to come back to my home. She would ask me, she definitely used to ask me every day. She used to ask me what the teacher had taught me. Just tell me, hey, Khushwant Singh, tell me what happened in the school today itself. What your subject teachers, they had taught you, mathematics teacher, science teacher, English teacher. But actually, she was not so much educated, but she knew very well the so many different subjects he used to study, and she started asking now, tell me what happened in the school. I would tell her English words. I started describing some English word which had been taught me by my English teacher, and little things of Western science. Western science, I mean to say, that's for example, if I explain about Einstein, if I explain about Archimedes and some other like Newton and some other scientists. Okay. This is called Western science, means those, all of maximum of them, they belong to Western countries. Clear? So about this science and learning, like the law of gravity, you know very well gravity. In science was, if the chalk is coming downwards, it is because of law of gravity. The things, the earth, it is pulling you towards itself, that is a law of gravity. Like Archimedes principle, the world being round, the earth is round and it revolves round the sun. All the things, when I told my grandmother, this made her unhappy. Means the grandmother, she never got happy. She was not happy. She remained unhappy. She was not satisfied with the answer given by the writer himself, because she could not help my lesson, because she was not so much educated. Although little bit scripture she used to read, lot of reciting prayers she used to recite with the beads of rosary. That was the continuous work of grandmother even after coming in the school city life. But she could not help me in my mathematics, in my science, in my English and other subjects. And she did not believe in the things they taught at the English school, and moreover she never believed the things. She used to say, what you have been taught in the school, means the earth is round, the law of gravity, what kind of useless things you are reading? Because the grandmother, as I have already depicted, that she was a traditional typical Indian woman. Clear? She believed in the sanctity of God, in the existence of God. For grandmother, if the prayer of the God would not be taken place, then no benefit is there for study and no benefit is there for any education for grandmother. Such kind of mentality she was having. She was very innocent lady. Clear? So now there was no teaching about God and scriptures. She was surprised, she was shocked, and used to ask regularly, there is a no study for God, there is a no study for scriptures in your school, what the hell is going on in your school? One day I announced that we were being given music lesson. One day I told my grandmother, oh my dear grandmother, our music teacher, they have taught us how to sing this song. And now this time she was very much disturbed. Means she started getting angry, aggressive. She made her mouth in a different way, strange manner, because to her, for grandmother, music had lewd association. Means very much few, very less interest she was having, and it was connected to very less people. It was not the work of the common people like the grandmother, the grandson, and like them so many thousands of people. No, it was the monopoly. Monopoly means ekadhikar in the translation. The person who performs the business, the person who works any, who does any work, and individually he is doing himself. Except him, no one other does. Clear? That is the monopoly. Suppose if I am the businessman of a particular thing, except me, no one else does this work, and that is the essential good. So it is called my monopoly. So music is the monopoly. It should be the monopoly of the harlots. Harlots means prostitutes. In Hindi translation, Vaishya. Clear? So harlots and beggars. Music was the work of harlots, prostitutes and the beggars. Means in order to earn their livelihood, they used to sing. Why common people are taught the music? Means why my grandson has been taught in the school, the music chapter, music lesson, although it is not the necessity of him. Means music must be the monopoly of only harlots and beggar. Neither my son, my grandson is harlot nor is a beggar. So why he has been taught? So she was completely disturbed. Okay, and it is not meant for gentle folk. Gentle folk means or cultural society. It is not the work for the cultural society in which they had been living over there. And she said nothing at that time. She kept her mouth shut. She didn't speak anything. And but her silence. But sometime. Non-verbal communication. Two kinds of communications are there. One is verbal communication, in which suppose if you are speaking, throwing some words in front of others and you are showing your aggression, you are abusing someone, clear. But on the other hand, suppose if you are feeling aggressive, if you are feeling anxiety, if you are feeling stress, so you are, although you are not speaking with your mouth, but automatically your facial expressions, your gestures, your body language, it elaborates so many things. So that's why her silence was speaking throughout her non-verbal communication, that she was disapproved. Means she didn't like. She had shown her disapproval towards the music. She did not give her consent. She rarely talked to me. Hardly she used to talk to me. She never talked to me. And after that, when I went up to university, after years had been rolled away. So when I started moving towards university, I was admitted to college. You know very well, boys. Now this time you are in 11th class, next time you will be in 12th, then you will go to college. Automatically means on all the stages you have to go through. So similarly, after finishing his school life, when he was admitted to college, this was the phase number 3, clear? I was given a room of my own, means now this time I didn't live with my grandmother, I did not share my room with grandmother, I was given a separate room. The common link of my friendship was snapped. Snapped means it has been distorted, it has been segregated, it has been broken. Clear? Snapped means broken. Snapped means torn or broken. Together in this way. Clear? The common link of the friendship between me and my grandmother, it had completely been snapped in this way. But anyhow, my grandmother accepted her seclusion with resignation. So my dear boys, this word has been given in a font alphabet. Accepted her seclusion with resignation. Seclusion means isolation. Clear? S-E-C-L-U-S-I-O-N. Means isolation. Akelapan. Loneliness. You can say that. Clear? She accepted her seclusion with resignation, means she had given her resignation from all of her desires in this way, that she used to love me a lot. It means the grandmother, she loved her grandson very much, but even then, for the sake of the future of the grandson, she had resigned everything, she had sacrificed all the things and decided to live the life of isolation. He means I would be alone, no problem for my side. Clear? She was a mentally strong lady. Clear? So she rarely left her spinning wheel. Spinning wheel means in Hindi translation charkha. Clear? Gandhi used to play move spinning wheel during the freedom fighting. Okay, freedom fight. So he was, so same spinning wheel she was having, and she hardly talked to anyone. She never talked to anyone. She passed her since morning till evening, the timing, by sitting on the spinning wheel from sunrise to sunset, from dusk to dawn, from morning, since morning till evening. She sat by her spinning wheel. She used to make herself sit before the spinning wheel, be charkhe ke samne baithti thi, and reciting prayer. One more thing you must underline. In the previous video, I had told all of you that she was keeping up beads of rosary manko ki mala in her hand, and her lips were moving constantly in inaudible prayer. Clear? So this was the continuous process of grandmother. Every day she could leave any other thing, but she could not leave her reciting of the prayer with the beads of rosary. She used to make herself sit in front of the spinning wheel and started continued her work by reciting the prayer of God every time, like ram 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 ram, in this way. Okay, only in the afternoon she relaxed for a while, maybe for half an hour, for 1 hour approximately, she got relaxed. little bit to feed the sparrows. She threw some pieces of breads, chapatis, and made some breadcrumbs and started throwing towards the sparrow. Thousands of sparrows started coming round her. They used to sit on her head, sometime on her shoulder, sometime on her legs, and it was an enjoyable moment for grandmother. And while she sat in the veranda breaking the bread into little bits, little bit means little small breadcrumbs, chote chote pieces, small pieces she used to throw into in this way. And hundreds of little birds they used to gather round the grandmother, and some of them sit on her head, some of them sit on her legs. Some came and perched on her legs, and in this way hundreds of birds collected round her, creating a veritable bedlam of chirping. Bedlam means mental hospital. B-E-D-L-A-M. Bedlam. B-E-D-L-A-M means mental stage, you can say. Mental, like the situation of mental hospital. So it was like a bedlam. Suppose hundreds of birds, if they are chirping, what kind of creepy sound is coming in your mind? That kind of bedlam was there, of chirping in this way. Some came and perched on her legs. Some of them used to sit on the legs of grandmother. Some of them sit on the shoulders. Some even sat on her head. But she smiled. She never felt disappointed. She smiled and never shooed them away. Shooed them means she never flew them away in this way. No. It used to be the happiest half an hour for her. It means it was the happiest hour for grandmother, and she enjoyed the company of the birds. So I think so, boys, you might have enjoyed this video. So tomorrow I will upload your next video in the form of your part number 3, and the chapter will be finished at that time. I'm sorry. If you have any problem with respect to the content of this chapter number 1, the portrait of lady, so you may send a message to me on the WhatsApp number in which you have already been added. Till then, take care. Bye bye. Have a nice day.